वेबिनार आई एम सुरेश गरमिल्ला द डायरेक्टर ऑफ भद्रका कॉलेज पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट सेंटर वेलकमिंग यू ऑल टू दिस वेबिनार ऑन वोकल फॉर लोकल द entrepreneurship as a career option. This webinar will be addressed by Professor Achalapati. At the first instance, I take pleasure in extending special greetings to Professor Achalapati, Director of Dhanvantri Institute of Science and Technology, and also the correspondent of Dhanvantri Sri Chaitanya Degree and PG College. I would like to extend warm greetings to Mr. Abhiram Krishna, the Director General of the Bhadruka Group of Institutions. My greetings also go to all those who are viewing this webinar on the YouTube. My greetings go to Dr. Krishnavardhan Reddy, who is going to introduce the guest at a little later stage. The program for this webinar will be as follows. Mr. Abhiram Krishna will give a brief introduction about the Bhadruka Group. Then a brief topic introduction will be given by me. And then Dr. Krishnavardhan Reddy will introduce the guest, followed by the presentation by the guest. And we will follow it up with question answers from you, which will be coordinated by Professor Rishi, my colleague in Bhadruka College. And then we will have the vote of thanks. So may I now request Mr. Abhiram Krishna to say a few words about the Bhadruka Group. Over to Mr. Abhiram Krishna.
Thank you, Suresh sir. Good morning, everybody. It is my pleasure to say a few words about our society. Seth Gasiram Gopikishan Bhadruka Educational Society set up its first college in the year 1950. So this year is a landmark year for all of us because we are celebrating our Diamond Jubilee, the 70 years of our existence. The last 70 years, the management has been engaging our students to convert them into an enlightened, spiritually inspired, morally upright, and a socially committed citizens. We owe it to a large number of our progressive management, philanthropists, corporate leaders, and well-known educators who have guided us in the past and who continue to guide us even in the current times. I'm happy that the Bhadruka College Postgraduate Center has chosen a current topic, which is very, very relevant, and also chosen an educator, Sri Achalapati Garu, to share his views. I'm sure the webinar will not only be interesting, but also very, very informative. Thank you, and over to Suresh sir.
Thank you, Mr. Abhiram. Let me just introduce to the audience the topic. Vocal for Local was a call given by the Prime Minister of India about a few weeks ago, as he was talking about the lockdown and the unlock period due to this COVID. We all know how much this COVID has impacted the world. COVID-19 has created enormous amount of economic struggle apart from health problems. We had to close down our factories. We had to close down our operations. We had to close down our transport system. We have to close down everything. And this is not restricted only to India. world over, barring probably a few countries, maybe less than 5 or 6 countries, most countries in the world have had a lockdown of at least 2 weeks, if not more. In this context, the Prime Minister gave a call that we should become vocal for local, apart from becoming Atmanirbhar Bharat. Now, both are very, very deeply linked. We have been under foreign rule for a number of years and probably have become very complacent as well as become very servile. We don't have a great trust in ourselves. The trust deficit in our own self is creating a lot of problems. We are not in a position to compete globally. Every time any challenge comes up, the common man answers, you know, we can't do it because we are a small, we are a poor nation. There are big nations like the US, the China, and the Europe. So we have never been in a position probably to tell everybody in the world, yes, we can. And that's one thing that the Prime Minister is asking the nation to stand up to. We need to put in faith in ourselves. We need to work. We need to become strong. And one of the best mechanisms to become strong is to support our own selves. And that's what is vocal for local. Now, at this stage, when we talk of corporate India, because basically that is the agenda that we are going to be talking. So corporate India, we see a lot of Indian MNCs, which have done great work in the last few decades. Infosys, the Tatas, the Dr. Reddy's Laboratories, Reliance Industries, Hero Motors, Bajaj, Aditya Birla Group, Britannia Industries are only a few amongst a large number of companies which are doing great work, and they have become great brands. Recent brands like Jola Footwear from UP, Dhona Jewelries, Classic Jewelries from Rajasthan, Napadori Fashion Wear from Delhi, are really doing great job world over. Now, something that I would like to draw the attention of all people who are watching this webinar is about Canada. Canada is a very beautiful country. About 98% of businesses in Canada are small businesses with reference to number of people. 98% of Canada's business has less than 100 people employed. And even amongst that, nearly 60%, about 57%, has only 4 employees. But having such a small size, what is their global, national contribution to the GDP? They contribute about 42 to 45% to the GDP of Canada. That is, when small businesses can do great jobs and become great brands. People like Amartya Sen and others are talking about 3 principles: reducing poverty, reducing inequality, and reducing unemployment to grow as a nation. It appears that left untouched, a lowly paid employee in India would take something like 941 years to get the salary of an executive in a garment industry. Now, that being the income disparity, we need to become very, very strong in terms of our local produce. The local produce, one, has to become qualitatively great, as well as it should seek a great amount of acceptance from the local population. We are not a small country in terms of population. We are 130 crore. It's a big nation. We contribute about 1/5 of the world population. And unless we consume our products and we speak for our products, it's going to be very difficult for somebody else to speak for our products. That is a context in which we are looking at local, becoming local for local. And in this context, what is the role of an entrepreneur. The entrepreneur should, as a career option, is becoming very significant in this context. And with these few words, I now request Dr. Krishnamurthy Reddy to introduce our chief guest, Professor Achalapathy, who will guide us through this process of Vocal for Local. Over to Dr. Reddy.
Thank you, sir. Very good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and my dear students. I'm R. Dr. Krishnamurthy Reddy, Associate Professor, Department of Business Management, Badruka College Postgraduate Center. I'm so pleased to be with you today and have a chance to introduce our guest speaker, Professor K.V. Achalapathy Garu. It's needless to say that even people are familiar with some of the reasons that employment can be a problem for most of the aspiring candidates today. Because of this pandemic situation, which is gradually becoming an epidemic, and employment, we all know that is under attack. As a professional group, we are confronted with the problems for which we must take some responsibility. Our speaker today intends to eliminate these problems and offer some innovative solutions. I have the showcase the brief profile of Dr. K.V. Achalapathy Garu, who has been our alumnus at Badruka, and he's currently a member of academic committee at Sheth Gashiram Gopikishan Badruka Educational Society. Dr. K.V. Achalapathy Garu is a retired professor of commerce from Smania University with 40 years of rich teaching experience, not only in India and Africa, but also in Middle East countries. Sir has more than half century publications, including 10 international publications at his credit. And he has visited several countries like US, Paris, London, Oman, Ethiopia, Kenya, Nepal, to name few of them, on various academic assignments. Sir has produced 10 research scholars who were awarded PhD under his leadership, and 6 students are in pipeline working on their PhD, and 5 students are awarded MPhil under his able research guidance and supervision. Some of his produced scholars today are working in premier institutes like IIMs, foreign universities as well. He has, to his credit, a major research project on implications of IFRS for corporate reporting practices in India under the sponsorship of University Grant Commission, Ministry of HRD, Government of India. Sir is awarded as a best teacher by Government of Andhra Pradesh during the year 2005. He is the past president of Indian Accounting Association, past chairman Board of Studies in Commerce, Usmania University, head Department of Commerce, past Dean Faculty of Commerce, Usmania University. Sir has conducted many national and international conferences, and one among them, which has really created a milestone in the history of Usmania, is International Conference on Implications of IFRS on Corporate Reporting and Practices during 13 to 15 March 2015. He was holding the post of Director, Directorate of Placement Services, Usmania University, Hyderabad, by the time of retirement. After superannuating from Usmania University, he is presently engaged leading a skill development institute by name Dhanvantri Institute of Science and Technology in Hyderabad. The skill development courses including soft skills, software skills, accounting skills, business analytics, GST, robotic skills are being imparted in more than 4 colleges in addition to the premises at Dhanvantri Institute of Science and Technology. Apart from this, sir is a secretary and correspondent of Sri Chaitanya Degree and PG College, Mahboobnagar. Sir is an elected executive member of Hyderabad Management Association and was joint secretary of Hyderabad Management Association during the year 19 and 20. And he has conducted several student development programs in more than 20 colleges in collaboration with HMA. Finally, he is also just a fascinating person, and we are all in for a treat today. Without further ado, please join me in welcoming Professor K.V. Achalapathy sir to deliver his valuable insight on the topic. Sir, all yours. Over to Achalapathy sir.
Hello. Can you introduce me the fourth person also? I know Abhiram Krishna sir and yourself, and who is the other person who spoke?
Professor Suresh.
Professor
Suresh. Suresh Garimella.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, good morning to all of you. Dr. Krishnavardhan Reddy, the convener of the program, the director general of the Bhadruka College, Professor Abhiram Krishna garu, GS Rao garu, and Professor Suresh, the other speaker who was speaking before I took over the mic, and other faculty members of the learned faculty members of the Bhadruka College, and all the participants who have joined here. It's really my pleasure to be with Bhadruka College, because I was the alumni of Bhadruka College. 1977, I passed my BCom from Bhadruka College, and I am closely associated with the institute. Even now I am in the academic council, as already introduced. It's always Bhadruka College was conducting good number of programs, and I have been participating physically. Now we have this program through online. The topic that is given to me is the voice for local, an entrepreneurship scheme for the as a career. Can we take up as a career? That's what he was saying. So let me share my screen to you. I propose to speak for about 45 minutes, and then we will go for let me open my program. Has not come on the screen, I am seeing. Is that the one? No. Hello? Yeah. Ade okka sa ade nenu try chesanu raavadam ledhu. Yeah, you can do it. ఓన్లీ థింగ్ ఈజ్ మీరు చేసినప్పుడు నా లెక్చర్ ఫాలో అవుతూ యూ నీడ్ టు చేంజ్ ది స్క్రీన్స్ కేర్ఫుల్ డన్ డన్ ఓకే స్టాప్ షేరింగ్ ఐ విల్ సే ఓకే Sorry for inconvenience. We shall take up now. Yeah, Vocal for local entrepreneurship as a career option. This is a keynote address they have asked me to speak. And next, please. Yeah, you can see this is my synopsis. Voice for local. What do you mean by voice for local? When we say voice, it is the expression. It is a strong will. It is a strong determination. It is a movement. It is a protest in case of negative side. When you talk in positive side, it is the advocacy. We advocate for local. The word local, we mean, we are in this particular context, we are talking in terms of make in India. What do you mean by make in India? I will be speaking. Then we shall speak on identification of certain sectors in respect of make in India done by our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji. Then what are the challenges in the task? That means the present situation like COVID-19, how it has come as a big challenge, and how are we going to face it, and how are we going to overcome it? And then we will go to the entrepreneurship, because individually MBA students should have two important features. Number one, they should have decision-making power. They should have decision-making capacity. They should have decision-making will to do it. They should have decision-making courage to do it. A person who cannot take decisions, a person who always would like to be number two and give only advices, a person who doesn't have courage to take a decision, bold decision, a person who cannot take risk in decision-making, such person cannot be a manager and such person cannot be an entrepreneur. An entrepreneur has to take risk. So can an entrepreneurship be opted as a career? If so, what do you need? We will take some case studies, and then through case studies, we will see how entrepreneurship can be a career. Then what is the expected behavior of an entrepreneurship? With that, we will be closing the topic of voice for local and voice for make in India. This is the synopsis I am going to speak. I'll take exactly 45 minutes and then we will have question and answers. Next, please. In between, for any clarification, you can chat and disturb me. No problem. I can stop and talk. Next, please. Voice by local. Let me explain this. Voice by local, if you talk in terms of this, if you take from the days of independence, it is the Gandhiji, Mahatma Gandhiji, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, who started the slogan of be Indian, buy Indian. He is the person who has protested against the consumption of foreign goods. He has given call to burn all the foreign clothes which were wearing, people were wearing. All the rich people during those time have burnt their foreign clothes on the road, because they wanted to that local people must survive and local people employment must be given, and we must support our local. Be Indian, buy Indian is a normative behavior. Normative behavior is no more existing today. Today we have instinctive behavior. We have impulsive behavior. We have youngsters always look for what is the benefit that I get. So this is a point which we have to remember. So keeping that into account, Mahatma Gandhi's normative behavior has undergone a change. Similarly, in the first Prime Minister of India, Jawaharlal Nehru, has given a call for build India with scientific temper. He gave a focus on key industries, impulsive industries, propulsive industries, strategic industries were started by the public sector during that time, because there is no initiative from the private sector in respect of Indian industrial development. So that was a initiative taken through the public sector, and slowly it went into the joint sector, then it went into the assisted sector. Then today we have an independent private sector market economy we have gone through. So it is a U-turn. It is a from the private sector only when British was ruling. Again, we have come back now today with a market economy and where public sector is losing its importance. Both the even the present prime minister is trying to reduce the budget in the public sector and thereby increase more for the private sector. So well, that is the second stage. And the third stage, when we look into it, Lal Bahadur Shastri was the prime minister, and he was the person who gave a call for Jai Kisan and Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan. Because we had a fight with the Pakistan and had, at that time, and at that time he gave that slogan, which indicates to create an temperament to, and the emotional attachment to the slogan Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan, to protect our borders and also to protect our livelihoods through food production of our own. And we have faced severe drought during those days. Where I remember that he gave a call that every Monday, all of us should not eat in the evening, even though if you can afford to eat also. So one full day, actually, people were fasting only to, as a word of prime minister. That was the respect we have given, they have given. Then we had Madam Gandhi, who was ruled for about 18 years, and she gave a call for self-reliance. Self-reliance was given more importance. And then at that time, initially they have started import substitution. Then they felt that exports cannot be made if you have too much of import substitution. Hence, import substitution was substituted by encouraging the production-based industries to import the capital goods instead of importing the consumption goods. So you import the capital goods, produce goods, and then export the consumption goods. That was the policy of Indira Gandhi, where it is called as self-reliance, through self-reliance. That was there till 1984, where she was assassinated. And far later, Rajiv Gandhi, when he became a prime minister, he gave importance to the growth, productivity and development. And in fact, you know, growth, productivity and development were the only slogans. And in fact, some of the social justice as a goal has been given up by Rajiv Gandhi for some time, which was started by his mother, social justice or anti-poverty programs. So that was the period from 1984 to 1991. We had followed the growth, productivity and development policy. However, when in 1991, we faced a disastrous situation where we did not have money. Even if you mortgage entire gold in the country, there was nobody to supply you any raw material because nobody was ready to supply you goods on credit to you. And we were in a disastrous situation during Prime Minister of Chandrasekhar when he was the Prime Minister. Followed by him, P.V. Narasimha Rao, our man from Telangana, has become a prime minister whose centenary celebrations we are going to make this year. And he has become prime minister, and he is the person who turned around, gave a call that look east, compete with the world. When you say look east, stop looking only west. Don't look west only as a source. Look east also. That's what he was saying. So he has built up relationship with Singapore. He has been Malaysia, Indonesia, then you had Japan. So like that, he has looked into it. With his starting today, we have more than 200 countries to which we export our goods. Wide coverage of countries has taken place in terms of exports. That is a big contribution of P.V. Narasimha Rao ji in developing country from the slogan of liberalization, privatization, and globalization. Then we had Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji in 1996 to the initially later, and then 1999 to 2004. Those 5 years when Vajpayee has ruled, the best thing he did is, unlike any other prime minister, I can tell you, He started a slogan. He did not leave with the slogan. He has shown that he can implement and get the results as well. That is building up the national highway. Four ways, six roadways, the sixth lane that side and six lane this side. That was the national highway. Even today, if you find all six lanes that are there today in the country, it is the contribution of Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji. Airports developed and seaports were developed and infrastructure was developed to such an extent. Good olden days, when I was traveling from Mehboob Nagar to Hyderabad, we were taking 3 hours in steam engine in 1988 to 91 when I was there, traveling from Hyderabad to Mehboob Nagar. Today, you can travel in 1 hour, 10 minutes in a super fast train. So that is the changes taken place. Railways, roadways, sea airports, highways, all are developed by Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji during those 5 years. Then we had Manmohan Singh, who was the finance minister during the Rao's time, and later he became the prime minister. And after he took over as prime minister, he has made India as a resilient India. The resilient India, because the real growth took place only during that time. The results of both Narasimha Rao and Vajpayee, who have built up the infrastructure, those results have come during the 2004 to 2014. You find the strong India, even though there was a world crisis, there was a crisis because of the supply side management, mismanagement by USA in terms of giving loans to the undeserving candidates, undeserving people, and all such irrecoverability of the banks. In such cases also, you find that change has come, and you find India was strong. Our YV Reddy was the RBI governor, and he was able to make our banking system so strong, and he was given sufficient independence, and he was able to make the banking system quite resilient, and we were not much affected, not at all affected almost, as far as the banking sector is concerned. And we had a resilient India. And 2014, of course, we had a big change. That is, Narendra Modi ji has taken over as the prime minister, and he started the Make in India concept. So this Make in India concept has come as a consequence of that. You find, I'm sorry, I'll silent my phone. Right. So you had a Make in India program in during the Narendra Modi was the prime minister, and the Atmanirbhar is the latest program that he has taken up after 2019-2020 during the COVID time he has given. We'll be focusing more on those two aspects. Therefore, I wanted to give you the background of the local. What do you mean by local? I thought of giving. Next, Mr. Basha. Yeah, Make in India, you can see the brand. This is the brand. We are going to speak entrepreneurs as a career option. This is a main lecture. Next, please. Yeah, this was launched with a logo derived from the Ashoka Chakra. The wheel denotes peaceful progress, with the lion stands for the strength and tenacity. So it's a strong country that was taken up, and it is launched in 2014, immediately after he became prime minister. Next, please. And what is the philosophy behind this voice for focal? Make in India campaign was launched by Prime Minister on 25th September. It's a national program designed to transform India into global manufacturing hub. What he was saying is, wherever you, from where you invest, I don't mind. Wherever you want to sell the final product, I don't mind. But you must make a product in India. That is what he was saying. Foreign countries also. The initiative is meant to cut red tape, spur foreign investment, transform India into vibrant economy. Nearly 3,000 companies from 30 countries participated in that particular conference, and that made, you know, a vibrant. Only problem is, later, some of our legislations, including the main problem was our industrial policy. We have entry and exit. Well, when you talk about it, entry is easy in India, but exit is very tough. There were morbid companies. There were no sick. There were sick companies, but not the exited companies. You have sick companies, and they were nursed. We are in a nursed economy. So if you go to West Bengal and other areas especially, there will be companies. If it is run successfully, no problem. If it is not run, the employer will stop paying the electricity bill. The moment he stopped electricity bill, his shutters are closed because the government will stop electricity connection to him. Automatically, workers are laid off. The company is closed. Neither the workers are paid compensation nor the salaries. They stop paying wages. Automatically, the company is closed, but there is no liquidation of the company. So no exit. This is a major problem. And another problem was most of the companies were taking loans from the government through bank, and they were not paying the loans back. So you have NPAs, and all NPAs were accumulating. And latest is even, of course, 2010 onwards, they started committees, different committees, Narasimhan committee, Baisal committee, and other committees have done. And those committees, consequent to that committees, insolvency banking bankruptcy code is brought out now. And this enabled exit policy easy. So people can now just give a notice. If 60 days, 180 days, if it is not paid, even a creditor can give notice to the companies, and thereby they can ask for the, the bankruptcy as such. So that once that has come, exit policy has come into the picture. Now, today we are in a market economy. You can enter, you can exit. Therefore, an entrepreneur can bring new ideas. That is what happens in America, where new idea, innovative ideas people will bring, and then they will start the companies. If they cannot survive, they will exit from the company fast. They will start another one. A person who enters and exits will not be penalized. A person who fails will not be penalized. A person who has failed will not be social boycotted. A person who is failed will not be looked down by the regulating authorities also in America. So this is a point which is very important for us to remember, that kind of exit policy also the present government would like to bring. In addition to that, we had some labor laws. The labor laws are also changed today. That also we will have to discuss. So this is a philosophy I have explained. Now let me go to the vision part. Next, please. Policy statement made by Make in India. Need to boost investor sentiment. That is a policy. Look at FDI in a twofold manner. First, develop India versus foreign development investment. We are not bothered about foreign, because foreign development investment was extraordinary by the end of 2014. Congress time. But what Modi says is, it is first to develop India, then for FDI. So your FDI conditions should be such that you should be able to encourage the investment for production in country, not elsewhere. Ensure corporate governance responsibility for effective governance. Boost manufacturing to help growth of the middle sector, middle class, and create jobs. Develop a growth-oriented environment, enhance ease of doing business, develop a three dimensions. What is the three Ds? Democracy, demography, and demand. As you know, three Ds. Without democracy, you cannot have delegation of powers. Without democracy, there cannot be devolution of powers. So democracy is a must. And demography, we are, as you know, demographic dividend is our asset. I hope all of you are aware about the demographic dividend, that age group point of view, between 18 years to 55 years is the major chunk of the 125 million population that we have. That means majority of the people in India are decision makers. They are the earners. They are the active people. People who are aged beyond 60, their chunk is less. And people whose age is less than 18, their chunk is less. So Youth India is the advantage you have. This demographic dividends was the situation in 2014. By 2019, situation today is, the thanks to the health programs, good health programs, lifespan has gone up. So people beyond 55, also their proportion is increasing now. However, attitude point of view, people think by the time you complete your 60 years, you are retired. So you are no more active. This is the bane. We need to come out of this psychological stigma and then say that 60 to 80, you can do wonders. It is because beyond 60, you are knowledgeable, you are experienced, you are analytical, you are matured in taking decisions. So, and moreover, you do not have any obligations to earn and survive. So there is no risk. You can take risk at that time. And thereby you can take innovative ideas can be experimented between 60 to 80. People can come up. So this is the time, and their guidance will help the youth also to come up. So I do not believe that if they work, somebody will become unemployed. No, it is other way around. Activity goes up. So this is called demographic dividend, and the demand can go up only when activity is there. That is the reason you must have seen recently also, lives and livelihoods dilemma was taken care as such. Next, please. Yeah, train manpower in industry aligned fashion, implement digital India for an informed citizens, roll out Look East and Link West, West Link, we don't want to leave, and also Look East approach, envision the integrated clusters with roads, rails, airports, associated infrastructure. That is the reason whatever the initiative started by Vajpayee, both Manmohan Singh and Modi also are continuing that particular, because key for the success lies in creating an appropriate infrastructure. A vegetable that is grown in Koilkunta or Kalvakurti in Mehboob Nagar, a small Polepalli village, can reach the Chicago or a remote of Phoenix of USA in 24 hours maximum or 48 hours without requiring frozen as such. Frozen goods also going up, processing of vegetable technology also we have developed, and that has really created wonders for our exports. So ensuring the state and central coordination also is the vision statement they have made. Next, please. I have picked up some views of the people. Kenichi Ayukawa has also agreed that the rapidly growing car production and demand will lower the costs of India. He was mentioning at that time, this is the 2014 statement. There may be something must have different happened, which I can speak later. Positive sentiment, huge potential and local talent of engineers is possible. That's what Franz Huber said from the Bosch company. Their group prospect too, etc. I have given those who are, since I am sharing the PowerPoint to all, you can read them later. I am not going to read sentence by sentence. Next, please. Then Ambani, of course, everybody knows that capability, as is evident from the success of Indian scientists of Mangalayan mission, he was mentioning, and need for global competitiveness, he was mentioning, openness to capital and expertise from the all over the globe, training the youth to the contribute to the making a vision, India vision, connection of goods to the services. This is what he was mentioning. Then Kumar Mangalam also said that IT hub and talent, entrepreneurship, raw materials, all these things he is able to bring up. Creation of 1 million jobs per month to service the demographic dividend is the vision statement he made. And you have group perspective also. Next, please. And Ajim Premji, as all of you know very well, Wipro, blend of Fringal and low cost innovative designs are most important. He brought out very beautifully that low cost innovation is the key behind the success, and which has carved unique position for Indian goods in global market. So Make in India is possible according to him, and India needs to address, however, servicing global markets to attain true competitiveness. You can be competitive only when it is low cost with high quality. Develop the organizational mindset to think. Prepare an educated workforce of thinkers and problem solvers rather than rote learners. This is very important for our MBA students, because we believe in that high-tech notes to pass our papers in the MBA. As long as you believe in the high-tech roadside footpath material to study and get the great degree of Usmania University MBA, you can never dream of becoming an entrepreneur. You can never dream of becoming a good decision maker. I am not saying this. This is what Ajim Premji is saying it by experience and by his proof he is saying it. Next, please. So identification of sectors. They have also identified the sectors which are to be developed. 25 sectors were identified, including automobile, construction, food processing, IT sector, defense sector, aviation sector, and many more. And they've also said 24/7 e-portal will be there to look after the interests of the industry. Portal includes major initiatives designed to facilitate investment, foster innovation, protect intellectual property. This is very important, because we never bothered about intellectual property, because by culture, we believe in sharing rather than protecting our intelligence. We believe whatever I know, I would like to teach to my students, either free or whatever I get, I accept the remuneration. If I don't get also, no problem, because I am contented. Philosophically, we believe in sharing rather than in protecting our intellectual property. But unfortunately, in the competitive world market, unless you protect your intellect, your intellect will be sold and your intellect will be grabbed or hijacked by others. Next, please. That is a bane for entrepreneurship. Next, please. You can see the sectors that are identified. 25 sectors are identified: automobiles, biotechnology, defense technology, food processing, media, entertainment, pharmaceutical, renewable energy, railways, oil, gas, leather, aviation, textiles, garments, wellness, ports, mining, IT sector, business process, manufacturing, ports, roads and railways, highways, thermal power, space, construction, electronic system, including defense system. They wanted to open it for all. Next, please. Yeah, very difficult to read this, and I don't think that I should spend much time, but I could only, this will be useful if you keep my PowerPoint. It is too small font as such. I don't know, it cannot be made big also. Unless I open my own, not required also. I will just read or give you what is important. There are, you should be able to identify the growth drivers in each industry. That is also done by the government. Automobile drivers, passenger vehicles had an excellent demand in India. Earlier, four-wheelers were not having demand because affordability and also not good roads. Bumpers were very high, but thanks to the six-lane road and ring roads everywhere in every city and smart cities that we are having today, and people are struggling, everybody is going for four-wheelers. Of course, again, now with the COVID, what Kiran Bedi rightly says, people are likely to go back to the two-wheeler, that too with one-seater. Mopeds may gain momentum again. That is a different story. But the key easy finance schemes and favorable government policies are traveling increased disposable income. These are all the growth drivers which made foreign investments also to come, foreign collaborations to come. We had Suzuki collaboration or any collaboration. we had, but Indian manufacturing is successful. So Suzuki with Maruti is most successful today. Then IT and IBM, food processing. Next, please. Textiles and garments also, you find that the most of the small scale and medium scale also, they have modernized. Thanks to the Shivaraman Committee and Ramakrishna Committee, the modernization of the khadi and village industries also has helped. And modern khadi industry today is no more producing only lungis and dhotis, but they are able to bring out this most sought after modern material also. They are making curtains and others also. That is really marketing help that is increasing the growth drivers. Our MBA people, many MBA people have helped the khadi industries to market the products, and MCA people were able to bring out the apps much. And then through MBA apps, you know, once we have made the educated people, as I can give you a small example to be, you know, a MBA guy or MCA guy goes to a small village and then he looks to the fields. A lot of agriculture is there. There he, with the laptop, he should be able to pull, connect the farmer with agricultural university and identify the specific. Today with the, camera which moves around, that will help you in identifying. It will take to a particular field, a particular plant, and what is the insect that is getting affected. He will take a photograph, and that photograph will be displayed to the agricultural university scientist. He will give the solution in within minutes, and it will be solved. That is the technology. The technology, high tech, is growing to such an extent. So we should appreciate really. Then similarly, construction industry is has got a lot of growth because of the government tax benefits that they have given for the houses, as well as the easy loans that they were giving through banks also. Next, please. Next. Yeah, drivers, I have already talked about this. High volume and policy, defense. Defense, they have more from earlier only 26% of the FDI was permitted. Today, up to 49% they are permitting. 100% FDI they are permitting in construction, operations, maintenance, and in specified rail infrastructure projects. Opportunity for domestic companies having leadership in innovation. Increasing venture capital and private equity activities will further provide the impetus to the domestic companies. Implementation of major reforms have taken place during the GDP. 4.5 trillion we were expected to reach during the region of 2020. Unfortunately, the COVID has changed everything. SMEs should contribute 90% of all the industrial units and 40% of the exports in the manufacturing sector. Next, please. Yeah, ease of doing business. You have steps, all of you know very well. Process of applying industrial license. Then server of services of all central government will be integrated through eBiz. And validity of industrial license is extended to 3 years. All returns should be filed online through uniform. And everybody is given a timeline. You must finish everything in 30 minutes, 30 days, or 60 days, or 90 days. Like that, a scale is given. Slabs are given. Time spans are given. And they are supposed to give the permissions. So this made ease of doing, that's what they said. Next, please. Yeah, you have barriers in spite of this. Boost to manufacturing sector. Though we said it should go up, by the time 2012 to 2013, it has come down from 1.1% to 0.7%. Even after that, also manufacturing sector got affected. FDIs were falling for some time. It was less. Help in reviving the growth. Low share of manufacturing into the GDP. 15% was expected but did not take place. Lack of ease of doing. Though we are saying ease of doing, really did not take place. See what happens. I can give you one small example. We were asked in the government office that you will online you can file and get it. Online we file and we don't get any reply. When you don't get any reply, when you make a call, they will say your document is defective. Please come and replace some papers. When we go there, we know what it is. The moment we go, replacing of papers means some papers are lost, and the clerk has to place all tricks, all such things, because we have not changed the attitude of the government sector, government employees, the psychology of the government employees. Bureaucracy has not, red tapeism could not be removed in spite of all technology changes that are taking place. That is a major barrier that we have. Next, please. Yeah, vision statement, if we find, this is all very simple. I want to appeal all the people all over the world, come make in India, sell anywhere, but manufacture here. We should manufacture goods in such a way that carried zero defects. Our exported goods are never returned to us. We should manufacture goods with zero defects. They should not have negative impact on the environment. Next, please. This completes the background picture. What is background? I have talked. Now let me come where we are. We are in a situation. What is present situation? We should speak. Then we should come to the entrepreneur's role to be played. I will not take much time here. Most of you must be knowing this, that it is originated in China. And the one politics we have to remember here is that the China is accused by the America. It has come in newspapers and also in the WhatsApp. Therefore, I am talking openly that China is affected by the virus in October itself, which they have not revealed to the public. And in the month of December, China has gone back to America, asked the president to sign the, they have a agreement with the America in respect of sale of products from China to America. In that, they have included a clause. That clause is, by the act of God, if anything happens, then the China is not obligated to compensate America. This clause was signed by Trump in December. And in January 20, the first COVID case is reported in the, America, and there are even in America, even in, they say only after the signing we got the cases, they say. But Taiwan has stopped American the Chinese flights in the month of November itself, and America has China has closed the Wuhan gates in December itself. So this is the main accusation on China by America, but it was not proved. But when it comes to America, America is a very unhappy. They would say, they were saying, we don't say that you have wantedly did this, but at least you have not informed us. In fact, there is a allegation that it is a biological experimental leakage from China. It is a man-made virus for which there is no proof. Therefore, nobody is talking about it today. But they have, what America says is, it may not be man-made, it may be natural, but you have hided the information. By hiding the information, you have deceived the world. Hence, World Health Organization also has not taken appropriate steps on China. That is what Trump says. All these things are only accusations. There is no proof. But what happened is, America has stopped funding WHO. That is a major decision, which we'll see in the next slide anyway. But now I would only say what is relevant to India. In India, by the time India it reached India, it is A2 type mostly. 62% of the 213 genomes have been grouped were A2A in India, and 41% were analyzed with that. 11 sign types of SARS and COVID-2 types have come globally, of which 6 have reached India. And epidemiological assessment suggests that the common ancestor emerged in the month of February in India and possibly resulted in an outbreak followed by country-wide spread. This is what CSIR, CCMB scientists have brought out in a paper that is peer reviewed, but still to be scientifically open for criticism today. So it is not this one. Next, please. So this is the COVID behavior. Having learned the COVID behavior, we don't have to go to the technicalities, but we are more interested in what is happening around the globe to know about it. So if you look into it, China virus confined to few cities, which I've already talked. Agility in handling by the China was very high. Economy is reviving in the China. Globalization makes it difficult for China to revive in isolation. They are able to revive their industry. Supply side they can manage, but demand side they cannot manage, because China cannot survive without the demand from America, without the demand from India. These two are very high. That is the reason China cannot be aggressive and fight with India also in borders, in spite of the provocations they are making today. So they want peaceful talks to go on, at the same time occupy the land. That is the strategy. I think all of you know very well. With all said and done, the most important relevant to our present topic is Make in India. My challenge question, which I will speak later also, is can you make in India without the help of China, except in food and partly medicines? Except medicines whose formula or scientific patents, etc., comes from either Germany or from Switzerland or from France or from America, west side only. Very less patents come from China, except in medicines. Can we make a product in India, whether it is watch, chips, iron, any product, including plastics, petroleum products? Show me one product which you can make without the help of China. So this is a bane for our, this is a major challenge for Make in India as such. So first and foremost thing to be done by any government is to invest money on the scientific developments, invest money on the, invest money on the innovations, invest money on the capital or key products, key industries, strategic industries who don't have investment. We only have consumption goods. That is a problem we are facing, where everything has to come, inputs have to come from China. There's a bane. USA is badly affected by corona and also affected by racial riots, elections, delinking with the WHO, which I've already talked. These are all uncertainties which made the WHO, what do you call, USA, most vulnerable for fall. As a consequence of that, because America is not able to import goods from India, our exports got affected. We are in very much affected. New Zealand and Taiwan recovered fast with early lockdown, but they are not good consumers compared to America. Therefore, we may not have exports as such. UK, France, Germany, economic fall is there and riots are also there. Indian lockdown, we have a major dilemma. I don't want to spend much time here because I will focus on entrepreneurship. Time is very less. I'll run fast. This dilemma, as you know, Keynesian economics and classical economics dilemma is there. Modi ji is following classical economics model. Raghuram Rajan also has supported the classical economics model only, though politically he did not give any statement supporting the Modi. Next, please. Consequences of this, you know, the demand and supply both got affected in India. Hygiene, health, paramedical, pharmacy, food, nutrition, online education, physical distancing, drastic fall in hospitality. Hotel, tourism, air travel, logistics management is a major challenge for all our Make in India. Logistics management is a major challenge because of COVID. Entertainment business today is a major challenge because the physical distancing is a major challenge. Because we don't say social distancing. Social distancing is bad and physical distancing is good for the COVID. Migrant labor is also a major problem. People, construction of industry committed a blunder by not paying the wages during the month of February, March, April. And because of that, most of them wanted to, they are going to die because they are starving. instead of dying isolatedly, they wanted to die with their family members, walked, biked, cycled, or run, or took lorries and then go, took some what do you call cement pipes inside, they have gone and then they have traveled, and such a disastrous situation. And now construction industry is saying that please come back, we will pay salary. Chetulu kaalaka aakulu pattukodam, we say in Telugu. That is what happened for construction industry. They have done a blunder. Though there may be few construction contractors who may not be able to afford to pay, but there are many large people, large sector also, who could afford, did not pay, and that is a blunder they have done. Then layoffs, loss of jobs, same thing of course are being done, unfortunately, even in from private colleges, are very bad to the teachers whose position is worse than the migrant labor, I would say. Anyway, layoffs, loss of jobs, closure of industries. Supreme Court also has given a judgment that you cannot force the employer to pay full wages. That's what they have said. So, because affordability is quite important, that also is important. Next comes to please. Yeah, you have MSME problems. I will skip this. Next, please. This also I'll skip because China competition, I have explained. Financial minister's package is also there. You have health workers, poor, farmers, direct cash transfers. Next, please. These are all known to you. Therefore, I am not going to speak. They are latest. Now we come to the, in addition to the economics, we should also know that labor laws are changed by the Modi government, increasing the number of hours from 9 to 12 hours. This is a major demand from the world trade, and this is a major demand from, because of COVID, they thought that growth can be, COVID-19, actually during the 2004-14, Congress government itself tried to change the labor laws, but they could not do because of elections. 2014 to 2019, Modi tried to do, but there were continuous elections, therefore he could not do. Now that 3 years, there are no elections, number one, COVID is number two, he used it, and then he started this. This was opposed even by BMS, affiliated to RSS also. So you can understand. Personally speaking, I am against, because making a worker to work for 12 hours continuously is inhuman. You cannot do that, especially when the large number of employment is taking place. This is the thing you have. But these are all the things. Hire and fire policy is also, these things will result in ultimately social unrests. As you know, social unrest is the voice of the unheard, in the words of Martin Luther. So this we have to be very careful. If social unrest will create, entire peace will be lost. Next, please. Yeah, specific areas I have identified. This also I have already spoken. I'll go to the next. Entrepreneurship as a career, if you look into it, because that is a point which they have given. I'll take only 5 minutes to complete this. Entrepreneurs can be the option for career. Innate characteristics are important, or can we make it a career option? Independent thinking is very important. Out-of-box thinking is very important. As long as you are in a cut-paste thinking, you can never become an entrepreneur. Kukku kakku in Telugu, they are saying, you know, you go on marma, what do you call, rot and reproduce in the examination, you can never become an entrepreneur. Necessity is the mother of innovations. Today you find the COVID-19 has given scope for many small scale people to produce large number of masks at the lowest costs. And the ventilators are produced by, even automobile companies are asked to produce ventilators at a low cost. Testing material is being produced at a low cost. So this is also very important. Then every opportunity is the other side of the challenge. When you go for challenge, other side is opportunity. Don't think that opportunity means dooms as such. Next, please. Let me explain some cases. 1995, a computer programmer started auctioning off stuff on his personal website, Auction Web. He understood that when the web traffic made it necessary, upgrade his business internet account. Omidyar had to start charging fees to the people. That has become today the Bay company. Site is the Bay. All of you know very well. Next, please. Howard Schultz, a trip to Milan, gave a young marketer work in a Seattle coffee bean roaster an idea to why don't we upscale this to the espresso cafe he wanted. His employer is not interested in owning coffee, but he gave some finance to him to start a coffee thereby, and also brand name is also given by him, and he became an entrepreneur. That is Starbucks. Today, you know, Starbucks is extraordinary. Because of the Starbucks, you go to, whenever I go to America, I definitely go to Starbucks. And seeing the Starbucks, we have started Coffee India also. Unfortunate thing happened to him. Next, please. Next slide. Steve Jobs. While they had been the friends since high school, two college dropouts gained considering the exposure to the computer world working on game. Say that is Atari. Apple founder also was Atari alumnus. They have done together. So alumni groups also can do it. There is a source of making entrepreneurship. Even Bhadruka entrepreneur alumni can think of developing some entrepreneurship. Next, please. When a couple of Chicago software developers got locked up in a restaurant, their lights went off and they did not get food on that day. That made him to start Grubhub. Even in India, you find that Zomato, all those things were started through app development startups based on this only. Mike Evans has done it. Next, please. Yeah, this completes the cases. So behavior, when you spend decades working with executives and business leaders, you really can't help but observe works and doesn't work over the long haul. One thing I noticed, it is not intrinsic characteristics of the human beings, but it is a behavior makes the difference. What do you mean by behavior? So you must be able to meet your commitments. One who cannot meet his commitment cannot be a successful entrepreneur. Next, please. Attitude is very important. And these are the 10 behaviors which I am going to speak are not expected to be there for an entrepreneur. Naivety. We all started our sort of wide eye and gullible, but the sooner you convert them into savvy, skeptical. The moment you are skeptical, you are out. The better your chances of coming up on the top. The reason is simple. Suckers and fools don't win. Learn to question everything. You question the existing system, new ideas will come. Panic. If you are panicky, you cannot become an entrepreneur. Nothing should disturb you. You can't override your adrenaline response and remain calm in a crisis. You are a sort of screwed up. If you are calm, you are out. You have to fight back the panic situation. COVID scares you, you are out. Jo dar gaya, wo mar gaya. Jo dar gaya, he cannot become an entrepreneur. Fanatism is passion, is a big success driver. But when you cross that line, yeah, you should not love the product. You should love your business, but not the product. If the product becomes obsolete, throw it, start another product. If a course becomes irrelevant, throw it, start another course. That should be your situation. We call it as myopic, marketing myopia. You should not be there. Laziness. If you are lazy, you are hard. Most people are slackers. Next, please. Go to the next. Yeah. Quick fix mentality. Steve Jobs, half of what separates the successful entrepreneurs from non-successful ones is pure perseverance. That's the success behind. You won't stick to it. Too many people want instant gratification. See, if you want success in the 6 months, 1 year, it will never happen. You have to base. You have to be ready. Acting out, you know, transferring them to the people you work with them, anger. If you are killing out, it's bad. It's kill your career. If you are angry has to be swallowed. That's very important. Selfishness, what do you mean by this? If you act like the world revolves you around you, you would better have the talent to back it up. Even so, being overly self-centered will diminish your effectiveness. Unless you have a giving attitude, you cannot become an entrepreneur. Next, please. Living in the past or future. If you live in the past, you are no more an entrepreneur. If you dream about the future alone and sit, you are not an entrepreneur. If you think about today, you are an entrepreneur. Lighthearted indifference. Your heart, you hear phrases like, whatever works, it is all good. No worries. Fate, what is there will happen. If you are like this, you cannot be an entrepreneur. You question, then only you will become an entrepreneur. Oversensitivity is bad. If you are oversensitive, you will commit suicides like our Coffee India entrepreneur or yesterday one, my colleague who worked with me at Mahbub Nagar, Ajay Kumar, as assistant professor of political science. I am very unhappy. He worked when I was a principal as a lecturer. Today he died just because his wife is caught in the corruption. If your wife is caught with the corruption, let her fight and let her face her music. You have to have be bold enough. And that is an unfortunate thing. Because he was afraid that in university, etc., she will not have face. That's not the case. So oversensitivity is bad for an entrepreneur. Yes, please. This completes my presentation. I am ready for questions. I'm sorry for taking 10 minutes more. Shall I mute or shall I'll keep it open?
Sir, our Director General has a question.
Yeah.
Can I ask you, sir?
Yeah, why not?
He says, what should be the role of an institute like ours to enable and accelerate this and make vocal for local a reality?
Three things we need to do. Number one, inspire, inform, sustain. These things are possible. Inspiration is possible by bringing the successful entrepreneurs and also failed entrepreneurs into the linking with the students. Quite frequent interaction of the entrepreneurs with the MBA students, either online or offline. Now online is there, more number of things can be conducted that will inspire the students. That is not enough. Inform, information is possible only when you identify the opportunities and show the challenges and give the information about the loaning, lending, government support, regulation, restrictions that we have. So we need to look to the entrepreneurial development institutes of the government, like Telangana Technological Consultancy, etc. Through them, that should be less, because people, students will not be motivated to listen to them unless they are motivated already by the through the inspirers. That is the second stage. The third stage we need to do is they will get informed, they will get inspired, they want to do, but they cannot, they have a fear, and also they will not go forward for two reasons. Number one, even a Marwadi asks, because most of the students in Pragati and Bhadruka are Marwadis. Marwadi student, I know very well, every student was having a bundle of rupees in his pocket, but he was very particular to work as a salesperson in a shop for 2 hours and then come back. I was telling, you are working like a salesman, what is the problem? No, sir, you should have to have a training, practical training there for 2 hours at least. And then we should practically see what is happening. So I work like a salesman, I work like a cleaner, I work like a mechanic, and then come back. So that is a Marwadi student does it. This has to come to our Telugu students also. They should have removed the inhibitions. NIT, my friend is there, NIT Mumbai, they will not give degree unless a student goes to the market and sells some products on the road. This is what practical training we have to do. That's what we have to do for the sustainable development.
Right. There's one more participant who has asked a question, sir.
Yeah.
Hafsa. She says, sir, can you say that how one can become a leading entrepreneur?
First, you must become an entrepreneur and work with passion. Automatically, you will become lead entrepreneur.
Okay.
You know, the best example is Virinchi Hospitals. It was started only 2013. But they are leading today. They may not be number one on par with Apollo or Yashoda, but they are leading. They are only middle class people. They are not rich people. Started that. So it is possible. First, don't wait for getting a best idea to become a best leading entrepreneur. Start with small. Automatically, best will come later. Next, please. Hope I have answered.
Yeah, there's a question from an MBA student, sir, who says, what are the three things an MBA can do in this context?
Three things an MBA can do is every day before you sleep. Yeah, in this context, yes. Before you sleep, you sit before the Google, open Google and ask for most successful profiles of celebrities. Okay. Successful profiles of the celebrities in the field you want to establish. If you want to become an entrepreneur, read the profiles of successful entrepreneurs. If you want to become an MD of a five-star multinational company tomorrow, you read the profiles of multinational company MDs from throughout the world, how they have come up and what they have done and how they have taken decision and what the challenges they have done. Before reading, don't sleep every day. Every day, one profile you must read at least. That is the first step to get yourself inspired and to be in the circulation. I am doing it. I never sleep a day without reading the profile as such. That's the first step. Second step you need to do is choose the career you want to take up and then start knowing about the companies which are associated with that and their profiles and how do you fit into it, what requirements they want it and where you want to go for it. That is the second step you need to do. Third step you do is identify the skills which are you are not having, though you have a will to join in such companies. Those certifications, you get the online certifications or offline certifications, get those skills with you in addition to the degree you are getting an MBA degree. Three letters of MBA will not get you a job, will not make you entrepreneur, will not get you anything. You are only eligible to become a decision maker. You become a decision maker only when you have a capacity to it. Your capacity building is possible with these three steps. Next, please.
There's a participant, Anjali Pandey. She says, how important is a public role in making programs like Vocal for Local a success?
Public programs?
Like Vocal for Local a success.
Who should make a... No, I didn't get the question. Can you repeat?
Ms. Anjali Pandey, can you just come out in detail so that you know?
No. Read the question again.
1 minute, sir. How important is a public role in making programs like Vocal for Local a success?
Yeah.
I think she means
to be
the role of a government.
Yeah. Public program is the job of the government. Public program is a job of the NGOs. Public program is a job of the institutions like Bhadruka and educational institutions like my institution. However, we do have to conduct the public programs by linking with the government programs as such. And the public program is to pool the talented people from different sources and make the teams.
One final last question, sir. There's a student, Mr. Naresh, he's an MBA guy. He says, sir, how can we identify entrepreneurial opportunities in our country and global as well?
Yeah, you first identify your strength, where your interest lies, where your passion lies. Whether you are interested in information technology or you are in agro-based industry or are you passionate towards the manufacturing industry or are you passionate towards this one, your line you have to choose. Then start looking into the Google and then look to the scan the environment, identify when you scan the environment, you will be able to identify the opportunities and challenges, which I have done today for this lecture. To deliver this lecture, I have gone to the Google and then I identified the challenges and opportunities.
Right. Thank you for your patience, sir. Now I think we have come to an end of this program. I request Mr. Rishi to propose a formal vote of thanks.
Rishi. Hope I have met the expectations of your duty.
Yes, sir. 100%. Yes.
Yeah.
Hello, sir. Am I audible, sir?
Yeah, very much. Yeah.
Honorable Chief Guest, Professor K.V. Achalapathy, sir. Reverend Director General of SGBBS, Professor Abhiram Krishna, sir. Respected Director of BCPGC, Professor Garimella Suraj, sir. Head of the Department BCPGC, Dr. Krishnavardhan Reddy, sir. Faculty members and all the participants. It's my privilege to have been asked to propose a vote of thanks on this occasion. I, P. Rishi, on behalf of BCBGC and the volunteers, extend a very hearty vote of thanks and mention our deep sense of appreciation to the Honorable Delegate Professor K.V. Achalapathy, sir, who blessed us with their presence and took out a valuable time of his busy schedule to shower us with such an exemplary information. I also wish to express my gratitude to our Director General, Professor Abhiram Krishna, sir, Director Garimella Suresh, sir, for providing encouragement and support. I'm grateful to our HOD, sir, Dr. KVR, sir.
Why don't you show your face, Mr. Rishi? Because sir. Why don't you show your face?
Yeah, remove that. Yeah.
Because you are not in the public.
Okay. Yeah, I'm grateful to our HOD, sir, like Dr. KVR, sir, for giving us an opportunity to organize this event. And I extend my big thanks to all the participants for their active participation in the event of our BCBDC department and all the volunteers for their support and making a successful event one, sir. The last announcement, sir, I request all the participants to fill the feedback form, which is posted on the live chat and will be sent to your email IDs as well. And you will receive an e-certificate to your mail IDs, registered mail IDs in a couple of days. Thank you. Have a great day. Stay safe and stay happy.
I shall be happy if you can send me the consolidated feedback, sir.
Sure, sir.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much, Professor Achalapathy. Very good, fantastic presentation. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Nice to meet you, Suresh sir.
Oh, thank you.